अस्सलामु अलैकुम, वेलकम टू द इलेक्ट्रिकल पावर ट्रांसमिशन कोर्स। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन कॉपर कंडक्टर एंड इट्स एलॉयज एप्लीकेशन इन ओवरहेड ट्रांसमिशन लाइन। इन दिस लेक्चर आई विल कवर द कॉपर कंडक्टर विथ इट्स मेरिट्स एंड डीमेरिट्स। फर्दर मोर आई विल डिस्कस द एलॉयज ऑफ कॉपर एंड देयर एप्लीकेशन। In the end, I will discuss why copper is not used in the high voltage transmission line despite of its high conductivity. First, I am going to highlight the name of the various conductors that are used in the overhead transmission line. Number 1, copper. Number 2, SCCC, abbreviated as steel cold copper conductor. Number 3, cadmium copper conductor. Number 4, aluminium. Number 5, double AC, abbreviated as all aluminium conductor or hard drawn aluminium conductor. Number 6, SCAC, abbreviated as steel cold aluminium conductor. Number 7, ACSR, abbreviated as aluminium conductor steel reinforced. Number 8, triple AC, abbreviated as all aluminium alloy conductor. Number 9, ACAR, abbreviated as aluminium conductor alloy reinforced. Number 10, galvanized steel conductor. Number 11, phosphor bronze conductor. These all are the various conductors that are commonly used in overhead transmission line. However, in this lecture, I am going to discuss the copper conductor and its alloys only. Other conductors will be covered in the coming lectures. Now, before going to discuss about the copper, it is better here to discuss what other conductors are available. We know that gold is also a good conductor and has only one electron in its last outer shell as shown in its atomic structure. However, as we know that gold is very expensive, therefore it cannot be used as a conductor in the overhead transmission line. Next, look at the atomic structure of silver element. It has also only one electron in its outer shell. Therefore, it is also a good conductor. However, it is also not used as a conductor in the transmission line due to the reason that it is also very expensive. Now look at the atomic structure of copper. It has also one electron in its outer shell. Therefore, this can be used as the conductor material in the overhead transmission line. Next, look at the atomic structure of aluminium. It has three electrons in the outer shell. Three electrons in the outer shell shows that it will have lesser conductivity compared to the copper. However, aluminium is widely used in the overhead transmission due to the various other advantages which will be covered in the next lecture. Now, question may arise that is there any element who has two electrons in its outer shell? It is because two elements in the outer shell means that it will have higher conductivity than aluminium which has three electrons in its outer shell. The answer to this query is that yes. There exist some elements who has two electrons in their outer shell. For example, look at the atomic structure of zinc element. It has two electrons in the outer shell. However, it is not used in the transmission line. Why? It is because the specific gravity of the zinc is very high, almost equal to 7.1 gram per centimeter cube. Due to this high specific gravity, its weight will be very high, which requires poles and towers of greater strength in order to carry its weight. This will further increase the total cost of the transmission line. Therefore, zinc is not used in the transmission line. Now, look at the atomic structure of iron. It has also two electrons in the outer shell. This means that it is also a good conductor than aluminium. However, iron is also not used in the overhead transmission line. Now, question may arise again that why it is not used despite of its good conductivity than aluminium. The answer to this query is that iron has also very high specific gravity of almost 7.85 gram per centimeter cube. Due to this high specific gravity, its weight will be very high, which requires poles and towers of greater strength in order to carry its weight. This will further increase the total cost of the transmission line. Furthermore, we know that iron always suffers from rusting with time, which reduces its life and requires special arrangement to avoid rusting. This will again increase the total cost of the transmission line. Therefore, iron is also not used in the transmission line. It means that from this discussion, we have only two choices of copper and aluminium that can be used for overhead transmission line. Now, I am going to discuss about the copper conductor with its merits and demerits. Copper is an ideal material for overhead lines owing to its high electrical conductivity and greater tensile strength. Just look at the figure, which shows that copper has total 29 electrons and has only one electron in its outer shell. This shows that it is a good conductor. It is always used in the hard drawn form as stranded conductor. Now one may confuse that what is this hard drawn. The term hard drawn simply means that the copper has been drawn through the die to the desired diameter. Or in other words, hard drawn copper is simply a copper wire that has been reduced in size by pulling it through a series of dies. Just look at the figure, which shows different dies that can be used to reduce the size of the material to a desired diameter and shape. This whole process is known as drawing. The copper becomes harder and stronger as it is drawn. Thus, it is known as hard drawn copper. Now, one may ask that what is the reason for hard drawing the copper? The copper conductor is passed through hard drawn process in order to increase its tensile strength, which is also very important requirement for a conductor material used in overhead transmission line. Therefore, hard drawn copper has at least 150% more tensile strength than soft annealed copper. Now one may become confused again with this terminology of soft and hard copper. However, no need to worry, these processes are performed in order to increase its tensile strength or flexibility. Therefore, soft copper is a hard drawn copper that has been heated and annealed. The annealing is a heat treatment process that alters the physical properties of a material to increase its flexibility and reduce its hardness. It involves the heating of a material above its recrystallization temperature in order to make it flexible. Therefore, at this stage, one may notice that when greater tensile strength is required, the copper is pressed through dies. This conductor is now known as hard-drawn copper. However, when flexibility is required, the copper is heated and annealed. Therefore, it means that hard drawn copper wire is a wire that is not annealed after the drawing process, whereas annealing makes the copper more flexible. Although hard drawing decreases the electrical conductivity slightly, yet it increases the tensile strength considerably. Just look at the figure, which shows the hard drawn and soft drawn copper conductor materials. Now I am going to discuss the advantages of copper conductor. Copper has high current density, which means that the current carrying capacity of copper per unit of cross-sectional area is quite large. This leads to two advantages. Number one, smaller cross-sectional area of the conductor is required. Number two, the area offered by the conductor to wind loads is reduced. Moreover, this metal is quite homogeneous, durable, and has high scrap value. Scrap consists of recyclable materials left over from product manufacturing and consumption. Unlike waste, scrap has monetary value, especially recovered metals and non-metallic materials are also recovered for recycling. Now I am going to discuss the application of copper conductor. Soft drawn copper conductors are used for grounding the electrical system. Short distribution spans, services and tying the conductors to pin type insulators where high conductivity and flexibility are required. Look at the figure where arrow shows the pin type insulator tied with conductor material. Hard drawn copper conductors can be used in overhead electrical distribution networks and longer distribution feeder spans. It may be noted that hard drawn copper is difficult to bend even in larger sizes where it is stranded. It is because hard drawn is the strongest but least flexible that make it relatively difficult to handle, while soft drawn is the weakest but easy to work with, and medium hard drawn lies in the range between these two both in strength and ease in handling. Therefore, to conclude, the copper conductor is most suitable for distribution networks where spans are short and tappings are more. Now I am going to discuss about the steel cored copper conductor. In this conductor, one or more layers of copper strands surrounds a steel core to make steel cored copper conductor as shown in the figure. The purpose is to increase its tensile strength. Now I am going to discuss about cadmium copper conductor. The conductor material now being employed in certain cases is copper alloyed with cadmium. An addition of 1% or 2% cadmium to copper increases the tensile strength by about 50% and the conductivity is only reduced by 15% below that of pure copper. Therefore, cadmium copper conductor can be useful for exceptionally long spans with same sag. However, due to high cost of cadmium, such conductors will be economical only for lines of small cross section. Furthermore, this conductor has smaller diameter and requires short supports. However, smaller diameter renders these conductors unsuitable to be used on high voltage lines where corona losses are serious. Up to now, I have discussed the copper conductors, its alloys with their merits and demerits. At this point, I want to clarify that in real practice, copper conductor is rarely used in overhead transmission line due to following limitations. For better understanding, just recall the four important properties required for conductor materials to be used for overhead transmission line from the previous lecture. Those four properties were number 1 high electrical conductivity, number 2 high tensile strength, number 3 low cost, number 4 low specific gravity. Now it may be noted that among these four properties, copper conductor fulfills the first two properties of high electrical conductivity and high tensile strength only. The copper conductor fails to fulfill the third and fourth requirement at satisfactory level due to the reason that it is very expensive and has very high specific gravity of around 8.89 gram per centimeter cube. It means that due to very high specific gravity, its weight will be very high, which requires poles and towers of greater strength in order to carry its weight. This will further increase the total cost of the transmission line. This makes its use uneconomical for overhead transmission line. Apart from these limitations, copper conductor has another disadvantage that due to its smaller area, corona losses will be very high in it if it is used for high voltage transmission line. This again prohibits its use for high voltage overhead transmission line. Therefore, in the nutshell, there is hardly any doubt that copper is an ideal material for the transmission and distribution of electrical power. However, due to its higher cost, higher specific gravity, and higher risk of corona power losses, it is rarely used for high voltage transmission line. Therefore, the present day trend is to use aluminium in place of copper in the overhead transmission line. The detailed discussion about aluminium conductor, its alloys with their merits and demerits will be fully covered in the next lecture. That's all for today's lecture. I hope you enjoyed this lecture. Friends, I upload many videos based on various topics of power system and motivation on regular basis. Therefore, don't forget to subscribe my channel in order not to miss my latest videos. And don't forget to share my videos with your friends and class fellows so that they can also get benefit from these videos. Thank you very much.